What's up, guys? Valence Ring here, and I wanted to bring you a new update. These are the June updates for Puzzles and Survival. And as you may have noticed, I asked Nova to marry me, and she said yes. So, sorry about your luck. Okay, I'm just playing. If you may have noticed, one of the funniest things to me, and it really cracked me up, was Nova can now be dressed as her usual AI self, or you can now switch her to Bride Nova. Very interesting. But even though it's funny, it does have some pretty cool boosts. You'll notice the fighter attack plus 10, shooter attack plus 10, and rider attack plus 10. So definitely want to get it. And how do you get it is a good question. You can see there's a little bit of information, but you can read that at your own leisure. The point is when you come into Global Ace Commander this week, she will be offered as a reward. As you can see right here, Bride Nova, 15 days. It's going to give you a boost similar to the Ace Commander frame, but instead of for 12 days, you will get her for 15. It is half of the Global Ace Commander frame, but if you happen to place well, I'm sure you're going to get both, and that is a huge benefit. Another thing that is released with this Global Ace Commander, so I imagine this Global Ace Commander is going to be extraordinarily challenging, especially for the people watching this video, because hopefully a lot of people are going to be attempting Global Ace Commander because of these extra rewards. But the other thing that was released is the new Epic Hero Choice card sixes that now offer Nam Hyul as a reward. So now instead of just Obsidian and Atropos, you will also have this green shooter that you can win for these Epic Choice cards. So I would imagine there's going to be a ramp up in participation for Global Ace Commander, an already extraordinarily difficult event. But if you already have Obsidian and Atropos at a high level, I have both of mine plus 6 red star, then this is definitely what you're going to want to shoot for, especially if you have Obsidian and or Atropos maxed out. This will be the new hero to get, and she is definitely going to help for Ultimate Challenge 235, I would imagine, because she is a 5-star green shooter-based hero. And into Ultimate Challenge 235, as you may or may not know, you only have green heroes to select, and there are only 3 5-star green heroes as of right now. After this Global Ace Commander, we will finally have 4. They did also release a new hero, and I will have to say, I'm not entirely sure why, but it is only a 4-star hero, and this is Shay Siyun. And she is a 4-star fighter-based comm style blue hero. Now, her troop skills are all troop-based, hit points, defense, and attack. So, but they are not passive. So I'm not entirely sure why they released this, maybe to balance out newer states with an additional 4-star hero. And as of right now, the only way to get her, and I'm not sure that there is any way, is in the mall or through events. So do not waste your Noah's Tavern coins on trying to acquire this hero. As of right now, you will not be able to get her in that manner. So I imagine that eventually you will, and that may or may not be the case, so that's still yet to be seen. But when they do finally release her into an event, or you can purchase her through the mall, at that point, then it is quite possible that you will be able to also get her through Noah's coins. But what you can do if you haven't gotten her yet is come in here to your not obtained tab, if I can say that 3 times fast, in your heroes and look and see, hit the get now button and it will tell you if she is available through Noah's Tavern. So don't waste a bunch of your coins, especially if it is not hero upgrade day, trying to get her. So that's the new heroes with Nova the Bride. Like I said, you're going to be able to get those from doing well in Global Ace Commander. So expect a big turnout this week, and they didn't give us much time to prepare. So if you're like me and you have to save for a week or two to really do well, well, guess what? You might going to have to save until next one. So if you don't think you're going to do well in this Global Ace Commander and you don't think you're going to place well, keeping in mind that a lot of people are probably going to revamp their efforts to get that new hero, then you might want to hold off spending everything you have on this Global Ace Commander and save up for the next one so that you can place well. All right, so those are the new heroes, the new bride, and then of course with the update came a new event called Fox's Test. Now, I actually can't see it right now. It only comes out every Monday, Thursday, and Saturday. So there are multiple times during the day which you will be able to attempt Fox's Test. It's a new kind of event, and it's pretty simple. And it looks kind of cool, but I'll be honest, the rewards aren't that great. It's a pretty easy event. You might as well participate in it. There are a couple notes to make. So there's a big room, and it's divided in half if you haven't done it yet. And it's divided in half, and we'll pretend my headquarters here and the watchtower and the shooter camp are aligned down the middle. So they will ask you a question, and you have to be on the right side or the left side of that line. Depending upon if you want answer A or B. So it's about 50-50 shot, even if you don't know the answer. Just so you know, snails have a lot of teeth. I didn't know that. but at any rate, so you pick the side that you think is correct, and or if you have no clue, follow the group. If a large portion of the group is on one side, go to that side. There was someone in my alliance who mentioned that they were having trouble reading the event, the questions. So I just told them, just follow the group. They're probably going to be right, and even if they're not, you still got a 50-50 shot, and there are 30 questions. You only get rewards for 15. So it does say once you hit 15 that you will no longer receive rewards for participating, so you can go ahead and exit if you like. If you don't want to exit, you can go ahead and stick around. The rewards are given out as you go, at least as of this video, so you don't, unless you're paying really close attention, which I wasn't, it will tell you what the reward was for that question, but then it sends out a mail and says, there it is. It actually lists what I won finally. So before this, I don't know why it's showing up now. Before, it didn't have anything listed, but now it does. Maybe it waits until the event ends, but these are the type of rewards that I won for the question. As you can see, I don't even know if there's 15 there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12, 15. Okay, so these are the 15 rewards that I won. The only thing I was certain of was the Nova experience because I never have any of that on hand. I use it as I get it. So I got parts. I got Nova experience. I got some cube upgrade material or promote material module, promote material, etc., so forth and so on. 3-hour speed up, gas resources, and marks of glory. Some nano weapon parts are promote material, enhanced material. Anyways, all good stuff. They're not huge, they're not that great, but it's free and it is a fun little event and it gives you something to do. It doesn't take very long to get 15 answers correct. Each question only lasts 30 seconds. So, don't feel like you're going to be stuck in there for too long. However, the one note I did want to make when you are doing Fox's Test, obviously you're not going to be at the ready in case someone attacks, and people may or may not realize that you are inside of Fox's Test. If you are in a war-based state where attacks on your sanctuary are possible, and you normally remain online unshielded, during, you know, the day when you're actually participating because you can react quickly, when you're in Fox's Test, you may not have that reaction time. And if you are in a war heavy state, I do recommend popping a 2-hour shield just for protection because you will not have the same reaction time. That being said, if you have to leave the test for whatever reason, go ahead and do so. I do believe you can re-enter. If not, for this test, then the next one that pops up. The only way to know that the test is coming, it is not listed under the underway unless it's actively happening, which, like I said, it only lasts for about 15 minutes. So you're going to want to look in under upcoming, and it will tell you when the next one is so that you can plan to be online for that test. So that's everything. I wish I could have shown you the Fox's Test because it's just your little avatar running around a room, and it's kind of funny. It was fun, but it's pretty simple. So the only other big thing is, as you may or may have not have noticed, my avatar has changed, and the reason being is they changed Flint to look pretty goofy. And that's just my personal opinion, but let's see if I can even find him because he does not look the way... Oh, look, this is Flint. No. That's not me. So I had to change my avatar. I really liked Flint, and I'm kind of sad to see him go, but that's okay. They do update a lot of these, and they, you know, they try to just reskin stuff to make it look cool. And, you know, sometimes it comes off really well, and sometimes not so well. But if your favorite avatar has changed, that is why it came out with the new update. And of course, you know, like this avatar here, some of them may add benefits, but right now the avatars in and of themselves do not. They also reskin some of the heroes like Atropo. I actually think this was a good change. I think she looks good. And of course, Flint was changed to reflect that new avatar. So this is the new Flint, and I like the old Flint. Bring him back, please. But anyways, you can go down and check those out, and that's just more for aesthetics. It has nothing to do with actual gameplay. One thing I did want to mention that I almost forgot is there were changes to Reservoir War and Nuka Land. So the big change is the gathering time in Nuka Land. We have Nuka Land coming up. And if you're familiar, it is a difficult event, especially to try and reach those top phases or top tier rewards, especially if you are a lower might player for the Nuka Land event that you're joining. You may have seen my other videos on low might players winning in Nuka Land, which basically the tactic is to just gather as much as possible and, you know, occasionally defend your mines, that kind of thing. So what they've added is a 10% gathering boost, and I do believe it's just constant. You don't have to do anything for it, but I will be able to confirm that in the next Nuka Land. However, I think it's just they increase the speed of gathering, and this is probably to allow for more players to have the shot at getting some of those top tier rewards. You're probably still not guaranteed to complete all the phases with just gathering, but at least you should be able to get closer. And because it's across the board, it evens out, so it doesn't affect, technically speaking, it doesn't affect the gameplay for your rankings, because everybody doing the same thing, it has the same effect. So it will allow us, hopefully, to do better in the event overall without changing anything else. And then Reservoir had some minor change to it, and I have Reservoir War today, and I'll find out what that is. But you can go to the Puzzles and Survival official Facebook page to check on those patch update notes. And, of course, you can check out my Discord server, which I'll put a link in this the description below, and I always have the patch notes fed directly into the server. So that is your June updates. Feel free to let me know in the comments section down below if you think I missed anything or didn't cover it properly, or if you have any questions about this updates or anything else Puzzles and Survival. As always, give the video a big thumbs up if it helped you out. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. And as always, guys, thanks for watching.